In the previous class, we have derived the variance, covariance beta hat as equal to sigma square into x transpose x inverse. And the diagonal elements are the variances of OLS estimators. Off diagonal elements are the covariances. And these diagonal elements multiplied by, and also off diagonal elements multiplied by the scalar sigma square is required for hypothesis testing. And sigma square is the variance of the error term. As the error term is unknown, we cannot directly calculate it. We will not obtain it. So what we do is, we calculate an unbiased estimator of sigma square as sigma hat square as sigma u hat I square by n minus k for the k variable model. In matrix terms, this sigma u hat here is u hat transpose u hat by n minus k. U hat transpose u hat is sigma u hat I square. We have derived it earlier. And if you take expected value of sigma hat square as expected value of sigma u hat I square by n minus k, it is equal to sigma square. And if you take a expected value of sigma u hat I square only, it is n minus k into sigma square. N minus k into sigma square. But we have not proved it. Let us give a formal proof to this using matrix algebra. Let us proceed like this. We know that y is equal to x beta hat plus u hat. X beta hat plus u hat. And u hat is y minus x beta hat. So that u hat is equal to y minus x into x transpose x inverse, x transpose y, because beta hat is x transpose x inverse, x transpose y. So u hat is equal to, we can write it as, we write it as I minus x into x transpose x inverse, x transpose y. IY is Y itself, then X into X transpose, X inverse, X transpose, Y. And we denote it as U hat as equal to MY. MY. M is equal to I minus X into X transpose, X inverse. X into X transpose, X inverse, X transpose is equal to, this is M and this is Y. Now, as you know, this M is symmetric. Symmetric means, this we have considered earlier. M transpose is M. It is also idempotent. M square is M. M is symmetric. M is idempotent. You can practice it. You multiply this with this. You will see that M square is M. You take the transpose of this, again you will see that it is M. So it is symmetric and idempotent. Also, as you can see, when you pre-multiply Y with the M, it produces U hat. So we can interpret M as a matrix that produces a vector of least squares residuals in the regression of Y on X when it is pre-multiplied by any vector y. So we define M as the residual maker. Residual maker. M is known as, because when you pre-multiply with the M, Y with M, it reproduces the OLS residuals. So it is residual maker. Also, MX is null. M into X is, you, if you multiply this with the X, I minus X into X transpose X inverse X transpose X will give you IX, X minus X into X transpose X inverse X transpose X is X minus X is equal to the null matrix. So MX is equal to 0. So as MX is equal to 0, U hat is equal to MY is equal to M into Y is equal to X beta plus U, so that MX beta plus MU, and MX is equal to 0. So it becomes, U hat becomes MU. U hat is MU because MX is equal to 0, MU. As MX is equal to 0. Now, U hat transpose U hat is equal to MU transpose MU is equal to U transpose M transpose MU. U transpose M transpose MU is equal to U transpose MU. So U hat transpose U hat is equal to U transpose MU. The reason is, you know, M, as M is symmetric, M transpose is M, so M into M, and M square is M, so U transpose MU. So U hat transpose U hat is N U transpose MU. Now, actually, this U transpose MU is a quadratic form. U transpose MU is a quadratic form, because it has the form A transpose XA or B transpose AB that we have considered earlier. So U hat transpose U hat is U transpose MU is a quadratic form. And its expected value is, expected value of U hat transpose U hat is equal to expected value of U transpose MU. U transpose MU. And U transpose MU is a scalar. It's a scalar. It's a quadratic form. It is a scalar, U transpose MU. And thus it is equal to its trace. U transpose MU is a scalar, so it's equal to its a trace. U transpose MU is a scalar, so it is equal to its a trace. That requires an explanation. So that is, the general result is this. A transpose A is equal to trace of A transpose A equal to trace of A transpose. Suppose that we have discussed the properties of trace earlier. This is an additional property. Suppose that A transpose A is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Then it is equal to 40. then trace of A transpose A is equal to 14, as A transpose A is a scalar, and trace of A transpose is equal to 1, 2, 3 is a matrix, and if you do this, you will get it as 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 6 and 3, 6, 9, and its trace is equal to 40. So the result is A transpose A is equal to trace of A transpose A. Trace of A transpose A is equal to trace of A transpose. Now, since U transpose MU, U transpose MU is a scalar, expected value of scalar, since U transpose MU is a scalar, U transpose MU is equal to its trace. That is the property. U transpose MU is a scalar. It is thus equal to its trace. And as you can see, trace of the scalar is 14, and it is equal to A transpose A. U transpose U is a scalar, so it is equal to its trace. Remember this. U transpose MU is a scalar, so it is equal to its trace. And using the result of cyclical permutation, expected value of trace of U transpose MU is equal to expected value of trace of MU U transpose. Trace ABC is equal to trace BCA is equal to trace CAB that we have discussed earlier. Since U transpose MU is a scalar, it is equal to its trace. That is, U transpose MU is equal to trace of U transpose MU. And trace of U transpose MU is equal to trace of MU U transpose. Then, expected value of trace MU U transpose. Since M is a function of X, M is I minus X into X transpose, X inverse X transpose is a function of X, a function of constants. Trace of M, this can be written as trace of M into expected value of U U transpose is equal to trace of M into expected value of U U transpose sigma square I is equal to trace is equal to sigma square into trace of M, because sigma square is a scalar. Sigma square into trace of M using the property of trace we have discussed earlier. So one property to be remembered is U transpose MU is equal is a scalar, so it is equal to its trace. So we write U transpose MU is equal to, instead of U transpose MU, we write trace of U transpose MU. Then using the permutation, cyclical permutation, trace ABC, U transpose MU is equal to MU U transpose. Then M is a function of, so when we take expectation inside, it becomes M into expected U U transpose, trace is here. Now, now, trace of M is equal to trace of I minus X into X transpose, X inverse, X transpose. That is trace of I N minus trace of X into X transpose, X inverse, X transpose is equal to trace of In minus trace of X transpose X inverse X transpose X using the property is equal to trace of In minus trace of Ik, because X transpose X inverse X transpose X has the order K, is an identity matrix. So it's a trace, is it's a sum of the trimer is equal to trace Ik is equal to trace of In is equal to N. This is I order K. Trace of In is N, sum of diagonal elements minus K. So if you take expected value of U hat transpose U hat, you will get it as this N minus K into sigma square, N minus K into sigma square, and dividing with this N minus K will give a unbiased estimate. So this is the proof that expected value of U hat transpose U hat by N minus K is sigma square. That is the final proof that we can see. Now, to derive this result, just refresh your memory about the trace that I have discussed, properties of trace, and especially this. This is a scalar, so the trace of this U transpose MU is equal to its trace. Using the numerical example, you can give it. So that is the proof that expected value of sigma hat square is sigma square.